seated. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. But I want to talk to you today.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Today, my text would be today that is time to clean house.
Yes, sir.
Amen. It's time to clean house.
Yes, sir.
Look at your neighbor and say, it's time.
It's time.
The clean house.
The clean house.
Now, when I say clean house, I don't mean take that same couch and put it on the other side of the room. I'm saying throw the stuff out.
Yeah, what you say?
Are y'all hearing me today? Anything in your house that not allow God to have free course and have his way, it needs to be out.
Yeah. Thank you, Lord.
Somebody ain't gonna like this today. Because y'all, a lot of y'all got junk in your house that Aunt Bertha had and Sally had 50 years ago. That's why Aunt Bertha and Sally were so depressed and died so early. Because they had stuff that God was trying to get out of their house. And now you just adopted it and now you just grab a hold to it. But it's time. See, God can't bless you when you're holding on to stuff that he's trying to get out of your life. Many times it's not furniture or other things that God's trying to get out of the house. Many times it is a relationship that you got yourself tangled and tied up with that God is trying to get you out of. I wish somebody hit me. I'm so glad I'm not a scared preacher.
Don't be scared.
Glory to God. I tell people in order to be a good preacher, you can't be afraid to fight. Because sometimes you've been in a situation where you got to literally fight your way out of somebody's house. But we are living in a time now where people need to clean house. I heard somebody say, sweep around your own front door.
Yes, sir.
Before you try to sweep around my house.
Yes, sir.
Matthew, the 21st chapter. The 21st chapter. And the 12th verse. Matthew, the 12th. The 21st chapter. And the 12th verse. First, God, I want to thank God for every fathers that's here and those that are not here. We thank God for you. Amen. Get the fathers a hand. A lot of good things I can say about the fathers and thank God for them. And quite a few bad things I can say about them too. But I don't want to change my topic, Mother. Because if I did that, you'd be saying amen, 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 amen. But we are living in a time where we need to just clean house.
Say that, preacher. Say that now.
Yes, sir.
Clean house.
Yes, sir. You're right about it, man.
Matthew, the 21st chapter. Matthew 21 and the 12th verse.
Yes, sir.
Heavenly Father, we thank you right now. Father God, we thank you for your word on today. Father God, we ask that you shake off tiredness. Father God, we ask that your people open their ears that they may receive your word. In the name of Jesus. God, tear down every stronghold that's not like you. That come to hinder this servant, that come to hinder your people. God, every listener, rather here in the city of Memphis or anywhere in this world, God, allow them to open up their ears and their heart to receive your word on today. In Jesus' name, we pray, amen. Look at your neighbor once again and say, neighbor,
amen.
It is time. To clean your house. Glory to God. It's time.
It is time.
To clean house. Glory to God. Have you ever get folks every now and then to come over to your house and find stuff that shouldn't be in there. And you get to their house, you realize they got more stuff in their house that need to be thrown out than you do. Amen. In other words, there's more folks got stuff in their life that they need to be delivered from than you do many times. But they're so bad and good at looking at what you got to be delivered from, until they don't realize you might need to be delivered from two or three things. But if they really do some research, they'll find out they need to be delivered by several things.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yeah. In other words, you trying to get delivered from that one demon, and they walking around with three or four in them.
How about that?
Because you only curse on Monday when folks make you mad, but they curse on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Amen. So that lets me know you need to be delivered from quite a few things.
Amen. Amen.
So we are living in a time where people need to clean house. Listen, we can't stand before God until we clean house.
That's right.
We can't stand before God until we clean house and get some things in us right before we can stand before other folks and tell them to get right. We got to ask God to deliver us in some areas. There are some areas we know we need help in. There are just some areas we're not aware of. There are some areas we don't know that we shortcoming in. Sometimes it takes other folks to tell us, honey, you know, you need a little help in this area. And some folks will be honest and say, I had no idea. That I was doing that. I had no idea that I was going that route. So many times we need to clean house. And as we begin to read, we're going to find that Jesus was the first one to clean some house over here. He was the first one to clean house. And many times when you clean a house, you're going to make some folks mad.
I know you're right.
Oh, this message is going to make some folks mad.
Oh, yeah.
I'm so glad they're not in Memphis. They're on YouTube in New York or wherever they are. But many times when you talk about cleaning house, you're going to make some folks mad and you're going to make some folks talk about you. But guess what? They're talking about you anyhow. So since they're talking about you, give them something to talk about.
Yes, sir. I know that's the truth. Yes, sir.
Matthew, the 21st chapter.
Yes, sir.
In the 12th verse. The 12th verse reads, and Jesus went into the temple of God. Now look at what it said. He went where? Into the temple of God.
To the church.
Into the temple of God. Around what? A folk be around God's folks.
Uh-huh.
I don't care what building you go in, it don't necessarily mean you're around God's folks.
That's it. Yeah, preach up.
That's right.
Said a word.
Why you say that, Pastor? Because many times instead of us going out and change the world, we ain't got so relaxed until we allow the world to come in and change the church. And if the world changed the church, that means the world had changed you. I wish I could get some hip up in here. In other words, if the world came in and changed the church, what used to be wrong to you, you begin to think that it's right.
About that.
Because you allow the world to come in and change the church. See, many folks got big churches because they're not concerned about people.
That's it.
Concerned about a big membership, which means if that homosexual can sing, put them in the choir. If that homosexual can pay tithe, put them up there. But God wants us to clean house and be concerned about the souls of God's people.
Preach up.
I know I ain't going to get too many views on this. But God wants us to be concerned about people and not so much concerned about their talent.
Amen. You got the message, preacher. You got it. Come on.
We so concerned about the talent of people.
Yes, sir.
Or she can sing, or he can sing, or they can play this. Listen, I don't need nobody playing my drum that's going to be looking at the little boys after they get through. And they don't look at it after they get through playing the drum. They be looking at them while they playing the drum. God wants us to be concerned about the souls of people, that we'll tell them, listen here, honey, I love you. I need you to play my drum. I need you to sing in the choir. But first, I need you to get saved, sanctified, and filled with. I wish somebody hit me up. In other words, I need you in the ministry, but I first need you to get.
Yes, sir.
That's why. That's why Jesus went to the temple first.
Yes.
That's why he went into the temple of God.
Yes,
he had to get the house of God right first. It was too much junk going on in the church.
Yeah.
Believe it or not, there's too much church, too much junk going on in the church.
Yeah.
You want to be entertained, you ain't got to go to the world. Huh? Go to the church.
Come on,
yes,
church.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Come on here.
Man.
Yes, sir.
You want to see folk bucking and jumping and having a good time, you ain't got to go out to B.B. King nightclub. Go to the church. So what God was saying, I got to go to the church. There's too much junk going on in the church. I got to clean house.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir. It take a lot of guts to clean house. It take a lot of guts to go to Bishop Lottie Church, and he got a wonderful choir, and he got a beautiful usher, and he got a beautiful church. It take a lot of guts and a lot of nerve to go up in there and tell him, you need to sit her down. You need to sit him down. You got to be filled with the Holy Ghost to do that.
Filled for real.
Thank you, Jesus.
That's it.
Because we living in a time now where folks will literally want to fight you. You think folks won't fight? You got more fight in the church than you got at these clubs. You got more fight inside the church than you do in on the whiskey court.
I know you're right. I know you're right. Preacher.
Just many times you don't hear about it, but it's there.
Man,
you ain't got to buy no tickets to watch a fight. You can just go right to some of these churches.
Man.
You got the ushers fighting over positions. You got folks fighting over choir positions. You got folks fighting over the deacon boy. You ain't got to buy a ticket to watch Mike Tyson fight. Just go to some of these churches.
Yeah.
Folks are fighting over positions. You ought to be one position you ought to be fighting over, the position of getting on your knees. That's one position you ought to be fighting to get to.
Amen.
I know you're preaching today.
Amen.
I know you are. Preach, preach.
Pastor, what's the name of your text again? It's time to clean house.
You got to.